You're listening to the audio production of Help Is Here, Audio Bible Studies by Max Lucado, published by Harper Christian Resources and presented by the author. These audio studies are a unique learning experience. Unlike a traditional audiobook's direct narration of a book's text, this production includes high-quality live recordings that cover the important points from each chapter, as well as relevant material from other sources.
He was the youngest kid on the field. All the other boys were in middle school. He was in third grade. Everyone else could handle a bat. He had never been able to get a hit. And they could pitch and catch and steal bases. He had a rag arm, slow glove, and bricks for feet. All the other boys were bigger and stronger and faster. He was lacking in size and power and speed. And when it came time to pick teams, he took his place behind the others and braced for the worst. The selection process began. I get Johnny. I'll take Tommy. I want Jason. And he watched as the three boys chosen strutted and swaggered in the direction of their captains. They struck the cool kid pose to make sure everyone knew that they had been picked first. The winnowing process continued, and the boy just knew that on this day, the last kid to be picked would be him. But then, something miraculous happened. One of the captains looked over at him and called out his name. I take Max, he announced. My eyes opened wide. I wondered if I'd heard correctly. After all, there were still plenty of other good players to pick, boys who were stronger and more skilled. But the one who had called my name was looking at me, motioning for me to come over to his team. You see, this older boy was my brother. And where I was weak in all things baseball, my big brother was strong. And on this day, my brother had chosen to be my powerful ally. Followers of Christ can say the same. We have been given access to the Holy Spirit. And like a big brother, he chooses to be our powerful ally. Now we learn about him through the writings of King David, Isaiah, John, Paul, and Jesus. Yet we often struggle with understanding who he is. God as a father makes sense to us. Jesus as the son is no problem. But the Holy Spirit, the term itself seems mystical and otherworldly. This is why I am so glad that you have joined me on this study, for the Holy Spirit doesn't have to be a mystery. You can understand who he is and how he works. And when you do, you will discover, as many before you have, that help is here when you need it the most. Early in my ministry as a young pastor, I tried my best to run on my own internal batteries. I thought I had an infinite supply of energy, and I was determined to study hard and counsel wisely and solve problems and organize committees and satisfy each cranky church member. I maintained my game face for 3 or 4 years, but somewhere in my mid-30s, I ran out of juice. Suddenly, I could not sleep. I would climb into bed and listen to the relaxed breathing of my wife. I would imagine my three young daughters snoozing in their beds down the hall. I would think about my friends and coworkers, each of whom were resting peacefully. Our dog was sleeping. Our goldfish was sleeping. But me, my mind was racing like a Ferrari in a time trial. I thought of church members to call, decisions to be made, tasks to perform. On more than one Sunday morning, I stood before the church having had little to no sleep at all. This was the season in which I found the Holy Spirit, or to put it more accurately, the Holy Spirit found me. In those late night hours when I could not rest, I would climb out of bed and pad down the stairs and kneel at our couch to pray. My prayers were moans. My faith was frazzled. I couldn't even summon the energy to fake it. I was honest. Honest to God, I was. As it turns out, God has a soft spot for an honest prayer. And little by little, the Holy Spirit brought life to my life. I began to sense Him. He led with a kind touch. He wooed with a whisper. Was He still mysterious? By all means. But a figment of my imagination? Not at all. One day, while studying for a message, I read these words used by Jesus to describe the Holy Spirit. I will pray to the Father, and He shall give you another Comforter, that He may abide with you forever. And I recall having this wonderful realization. I know that person. Now, that was 3 decades ago. I no longer think of the Holy Spirit as the holy who. Today, I recognize the Holy Spirit as my ally, my champion, advocate, and guide. He is the executor of God's will, come to infuse us with strength, the one who equips us not to just get by, but to actually thrive and shine forth and live the abundant life that Jesus spoke about so often. This power is critical in the life of a believer. In fact, it was so important to Jesus that His disciples have this power, that He did not allow them to begin their ministries until they received it. As He prepared to depart the world, He said to them, "Don't begin telling others yet. Stay here in the city until the Holy Spirit comes and fills you with power from heaven." Now, by this point, the disciples had spent 3 years in training. They had sat with Jesus around campfires, walked with Him through cities, and witnessed Him banish disease and command demons. They knew His favorite food, jokes, and hangouts. They'd even seen the empty tomb and touched His resurrected body and spent 40 days listening to the resurrected Christ teach about the kingdom of God. But they were not ready. They needed more. So Jesus instructed them, "Do not leave Jerusalem, but wait for the gift my Father promised, which you have heard me speak about." And then He made this important promise to them. "You will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes on you, and you will be my witnesses."
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.